Hello everyone, welcome back. In today's tutorial we are going to see how we can detect multiple car objects and image. Just like this one, we have two car objects and we want to draw a bounding box around each object, just like this would be the result of our algorithm. So in the first stage, what we do is we train a classifier which will tell us the image is a car, either it is a background. The second stage, we apply this detection throughout our complete image. We train our classifier on sub images such as 40 cross 100 image size. Then we implement this thing to our complete image. We will check at each location either it is a car or a background. Either it is a car or background, then we will draw a bounding box upon the classifier results. So for training classifier, we need training data of car objects and the background. This data can be easily downloaded from this website. This website contains training images. In training images, there are our objects and the backgrounds. There are plenty of hundreds of images that are available for training. Then we have the other folders, test images and test images scaled one. So let's see how it's gonna work. It's important to note that the training images has the dimension of 40 cross 100. That is a small size, small sub image of a complete large image. The second thing is we are going to use a feature which are hog features. And the third thing is our classifier would be sport vector machine SVM classifier, and it would be a binary classifier that would only tell either it's a car image or it is a background. So let's see how it's working. The first stage is reading training images. When you are working with a lot of images, maybe 100 or thousands, you cannot load all these images together in the MATLAB, because it would consume too much memory on the computer and your MATLAB would crash. To avoid this thing, we use image data store that will read the all the content which is available in train images folder, also in subfolders, and its label is either is a car or no car. So let's execute this. The next thing is when we have this data store, we can read multiple images in this data store. Just if the value of k is an index of different files in the image data store, if the file index is between 1 and 550, that would be car image, because we can see here in the car there are 550 images. And the second thing, here there are 500 images. So first 550 images of the car and the rest of the images would be about the background. Let's say we have this number. So this is a car, and these dots are its hog features. Try another number. This is the background. Again the background. This is the car image. So how you can access image data stores and display it. The next thing is we are going to extract features for all training images and store them in a vector. So this thing is going to implement for feature detection. And the properties are 2 by 2 cell size. And let's compute this one. The next thing is, when we have all the features, training features, the next thing we do is we train a classifier. In classifier we give the features and their respective labels, so car or no car. So our classifier is trained, which has a name classifier. Now test this classifier against our training images. We know 11 is the image of, definitely would be the image of the car. So let's see how it behaves. So it's working well. It know this is car object. Let's change another image. It says this is not a car. Let's try. It says this is the car. So it's working pretty well. And next thing is, we want to save this classifier for future users, because we don't want to train a classifier again and again, and we want to save our time for runtime application. So save it. This will be saved in your respective folder. So our classifier has been trained. Four images which have the dimension of 40x100, but in actual the image which are given in the test folder have just like this one. This is very small sub image of actual test images, and the size of the test images is very large, just like let's say clear all. So this would be the test image, and our trainer classifier is trained on sub images. So we need to develop an algorithm which will run through all these sub images and try to determine how at what location there is a car. How it works, you can easily see how it's working. This is kind of sliding window operation. We move window throughout each location and try to determine at what location there is object present or not. So this is the second thing we are going to implement. We are loading our classifier. Reading data store. Then again performing sliding window operation. This is a test image. So it has detected two two cars and drawn a bounding box around each object. So this is a workflow: training a classifier and applying a sliding window operation just like this one, and draw a bounding box around each image. So this is a complete workflow. If you want to get the code of this algorithm, you can give your email in the comment section. And if you have any confusion about how to implement this algorithm, you can give your feedback in the comment section. Thanks for watching, and please subscribe to this YouTube channel.